So, guys, can you tell us a bit about your characters, please?
They're little.
I suppose when you meet them, they've... we kind of made up a backstory where they were miners.
Okay.
And went down the mine before the queen took over, the wicked queen. And then when they came up, she had laid waste and was bereft of life and joy.
And their families had all gone.
Their families had all gone, so they turn into kind of highwaymen, kind of bandits. So when you meet them, I think you're unsure if they're good or bad.
Yeah.
And it was that kind of shadow coming over the land from the queen that they got greed. Where the queen's got vanity, we got greed and we collected gold and things like that, like magpies, you know. Mm-hmm. And that was our kind of darkness, you know.
How did you decide that backstory? Did you get together and have
Rupert had an idea and then we all just kind of talked through it. Yeah. It's very interesting. Like I was saying, it's important that they're a different tribe with their own flaws, I suppose, because when you meet them, they've kind of gone down a bad path. And they are, they're kind of, they're like magpies, you know. So you're kind of wondering, are Snow White in danger and, you know, all that kind of stuff. So it was interesting playing with that. How potentially bad are they and at what point do they turn around and all that kind of stuff, you know.
And they start to change really when Snow White
appears. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And the heart of them starts to, wherever she goes, she brings this beauty, you know, the goodness. And it starts to affect them.
How did you prepare for the roles? Did you have to like spend time walking. With
your... yeah, lots of funny walking.
Really?
Yeah. Well, we had to learn to move like you was 3'6" instead of being 5'10".
And match our walk
with the guys who were going to be with us, you know, the boys who played us, really, you know, and girls who played us. So there was plenty of that kind of going on.
So you spent quite a lot of time with your body doubles then?
I couldn't get rid of mine. My mine used to follow me home. And, you know, I'd turn around in the pub and he'd be standing. What do you want?
With the face prosthetic.
Would you go away? All right, I'm busy.
You know. People were wondering why
he's got my head on, like, you know. He robbed 3 banks and I got the blame for it.
Yeah, he's not as tall as he looks on screen, they said.
Right, I didn't know you had an 8-year-old son.
What were your what was your favourite scene to film?
Campfire scene was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. I kind of like the one around the fire because I'm a bit...
There's a great scene, where they're kind of lamenting the...
where Johnny sings and that.
Yeah. That
was a great, I like that scene actually, you know.
Explaining to Snow White what happened to the dwarves and lamenting the loss of their family.
Plenty of farting and burping going
on. Yeah, that was
after that. I remember that thing, No, it was though. It was these kind of beastie men, you know, these men just getting drunk and, but actually getting emotional when they get drunk and talking about their loss and the anger of that and, you know.